Hello?
Hello? Darling, communism. Oh, I'm so sorry to disturb you at work, sweetie. But communism, I just can't get the Black Panthers out of my head.
You're still obsessed with adopting those black revolutionary babies?
The Black Panther Party appears flexible enough to accept Marxist ideas. It is a small collective of young black people, the majority of whom come from the black intelligentsia, students, teachers, and a professor or two.
Don't forget about your gout. Darling, I told you, you'll just stay home after the baby's grown.
The countless chores collectively known as housework, cooking, washing dishes, doing laundry, making beds, sweeping, shopping, so on and so on, apparently consume some 3,000 to 4,000 hours of the average housewife's year. The woman has been isolated in the home, forced to carry out work that is considered unskilled, the work of giving birth to, raising, disciplining, and servicing the worker for production.
Oh, that's the reason for adopting. A little fight against the politics of reproduction, huh? Come on, honey, there is something called biology. But why the Black Panthers? Angela, I can't quite remember, but you know that little mousy little Fisher. I think she said something about... Oh, honey, sorry. Of course I never agreed with her on this point. Woot was just always... Well, Miss Woodfisher was in many ways a visionary with regards to my sexual ethics, but she was totally fucked up about race.
Over the years, I've unfortunately grown accustomed to a much more subtle racism among the left. Racism is a much more clandestine, much more hidden kind of phenomena, but at the same time, it's perhaps far more terrible than it's ever been.
Angela, do we really have to go over this again?
Unfortunately, it is our burden always to have to go over
Angela,
this again.
Don't you think I already know this?
Knowledge is not what's at issue here. It's words, action, and responsibility that counts.
Angela.
Goodbye, my darling communism.
Angela, hold on.
I, vaginal UNESCO Davis, blessed be the goddess that I was not born a man. Where's my music? I was hatched from the primordial ooze of the La Brea tar pits, fully formed as you see me now, braised in the Los Angeles, California inversion layer. I grew up in an all-female household. No men were allowed, ever. I only saw men on our old black and white Emerson TV screen. My late mother, Mary Magdalena Duplantier, came into her own back in the late 1960s and early 1970s as the leader of a group of multiracial women with weapons. Women with weapons. Women with weapons. Women with weapons. Fighting to establish a feminist state somewhere in Palestine. Some in her group were working class. Others were privileged, like some of you. What they drilled into me from an early age is that you can't change institutions. Institutions change you. Beware the cautionary tale of trying to take over positions of power that you were initially fighting against. In the words of my immortal mother, I'd rather suck the three horns and hooves of the Grand Cyclops of the Ku Klux Klan than deal with a well-meaning white liberal. If you've been paying close attention, you might be thinking, didn't she just say something about being hatched? And now she's talking about having a childhood. Oh, there's the music now. Well, I've always felt sorry for those who only have one limited way of viewing their past. Since I'm an Angelina, it's something of a miracle that I have never learned to drive a car and have no desire to own one. What does a warrior high priestess and temple prostituta need with a frick fracking, fossil fuel, forsaken philosophy? For over a decade, I have lived in beautiful but bleak Berlin, Germany, where everyone rides bicycles, almost everyone, and takes public transport. There are dark rooms in the organic supermarket, broad-shouldered, lovely, flirtatious women, and pigeon-chested Prussian gentlemen trailing along after them. Then there's the so-called enchantment of little old New York. Heavens to Miss Murgatroyd, that most shiny of dullard boutique cities. So many people forced to become walking careers in perpetual network mode. Poor dears, I can't really blame them. They just don't know any better. Working 4 or 5 slave wage jobs to try to pay rent that are $5,000, $10,000. Why not $1 million a month as the new norm? Across the globe are constantly hammering at us to buckle down when softy buckle down and pull ourselves up by the proverbial bootstrap. That's danger capitalism for let them eat cake. How much longer do we have to wait till the trickle down effect start coming our way? We've already been waiting since Reaganomics. If it doesn't take root in this life, it will certainly happen to us in the next if we just work very, very hard and don't complain or whine. I've heard that story before. working with the artist collective Cheap since its inception. Founded in 2001 in Berlin by our fearless leader, Susanna Zanza, with film historian Marcuse Siegelstein, and translator to the academic stars, Daniel Hendrickson, the Jewish Muslim. Cheap wanted to put more whimsy and less dogma into the art stratosphere. Cheap doesn't believe in guilty pleasures, and we hate hetero kitsch. You know, the act of pretending with a wink and a smirk that you feel superior to something when in actuality you really adore it. And while we're at it, let's just call a spade and a coon to kink. The imagery and sound behind me is from Cheap's 2009 Communist Bigamist, Two Love Stories, in which Austrian communist Ruth Fischer, played by my colleague in Susanna Zaxe, and Afro-American human rights scholar Angela Davis, played by little tiny 5'2" me, join forces for an evening of analysis and anarchy around the themes of sex and radical politics. As far as I know, the two women, Ruth Fischer and Angela Davis, never met in the fleshy flesh. But that shouldn't stop us from imagining that they had. You can't speculate about the future if you're not willing to speculate about the past. But Ruth Fischer and Angela Davis aren't our only heroines. Cheap Collective are firm believers in forming international copulation with other entities who don't want to dilute their leftist, Marxist, and socialist roots. Although we're not going to ask anyone to pass an ideology test.
Die kontrasexuelle Gesellschaft beschließt die Abschaffung der Prostitution und der Pornografie als Praktiken, mit denen im heterozentristischen Repräsentationsregime und mit der im Körper erzeugten Lustmaskulinität und Femininität konstruiert und legitimiert werden.
Gloria Berlin G.B. Jones, Jane County, Frank, the Jewish lesbian folk singer,
die Kontrasexualität will eine Kontraproduktion von Lust und Wissen im Rahmen
Alice
eines Systems kontrasexueller Kontraökonomie entwickeln.
Sal Mineo, European transgender legend Zazie Depardieu,
die Veröffentlichung kontrasexueller, kontrapornografischer Bilder
and the girls of the voluptuous horror of Karen Black,
die Kontraprostitution,
political pranksters, the Madame Defarges, militants, the Fist of Diana,
als kulturelle Kontraproduktionsweisen,
Max Jorge Hinderer Cruz, Julie Tolentina,
die kontrasexuelle Gesellschaft erkennt die Möglichkeit eines sexuellen Akts an, der als Arbeit betrachtet wird und fordert, dass Prostitution als legitime Form sexueller Arbeit anerkannt wird.
The originator of the Contra-Sexual Manifesto, which you've been hearing behind me.
Haben das Recht auf freie und gleiche Arbeit.
When you climb into bed tonight, whether you're alone or not, it's really none of my business.
Alle Sexarbeiter sollen von den gleichen legalen, medizinischen und ökonomischen Vorteilen profitieren,
very
different alle anderen von Gewerkschaften geschützten Arbeiter aus.
All those boys, they got it wrong. You know, Tired Freud and Icky Lacan.
Und ihre Rechte sollen denen
Their little
penises
are not the holy object.
Die Form eines the dildo is. Zwischen
and
einem
always was.
Und einem
Their appendages
und
are just one
annehmen.
Possible replacement among a plethora
for the dildo.
And I might add,
lesbischer Körper oder
not a particularly reliable or attractive one at that. Haven't the feeling done. Thank you very much.